from your point of view as a retailer selling these things, they did a pretty good job of the whole concept of the toy and the tie-in and so forth.
I think they did a sensational job. Not just the quality, but if you look at the detail in the product and the fact that they were able to build a lot of character, not only in the actual characters in the movie, but in the toy themselves. If you look at some of the items, you'll see what I'm talking about.
So that Lucas was, in effect, a genius as far as toy characters.
Well, I wouldn't be the first person to say that Lucas was a genius, but yes, he was a genius in the design of this particular, you know, the sequence and the product itself, of course, was a byproduct of his movie, but I don't think he envisioned it being so large in the toy industry. I think this was a surprising byproduct, and I'm sure he's very happy with it.
Hey, Star Wars fans, welcome back. Listen, I thought it'd be good to take us back to where it all began, for all of us, the vintage era. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Listen, I thought it'd be really cool. We started this channel out, I'd say maybe a month ago, and I would just like to first say thank you to all of the really nice, kind words, comments that you guys have sent out to me, and you guys are all awesome. And I do what I can to get back to all you guys, and I just want to say I do the best that I can. I'm not a know-it-all. I've just been a Star Wars fan since I was 7, and you know, I kind of wing it as I go. So I just wanted to say one more time, thanks so much for hopping on the channel. I really do appreciate you guys, and I have such a blast doing it. So listen, you know, I thought it'd be good to go back to where it all started, where all this fandom started for all of us, right, is the vintage collection. And I love the vintage, obviously. I'm 51 years old, and Star Wars was what, you know, it was over for me after Star Wars, right? So, and for all of us. But, you know, the toys is where it kicked off. And, you know, as a Star Wars fan, we've talked about this. I mentioned it in some of the other videos, but there's all type of collection types, right? Whether you're into the vintage toys or whether you're into the new modern era of toys, you know, and if you've got the sickness like I have, you know, where you're carrying life size, you're carrying premium format, you're carrying dioramas, you're carrying studio scale, vintage, it's hard to keep up with all of it, but my heart lies with vintage for sure. So let's go over all the vintage that I have. Real quick before I get into it, I'm the collector that remembers when I was a kid and playing with these things. So I think it's awesome. A lot of you collectors out there that have them in the boxes and they're sealed and it's like, wow. But I like to feely touchy and just remember, you know? So let's take a look. Hey friends. So what I'm gonna show you is my collection of the vintage, whether it was, of course, the Kenner toys. I have a variety of different things, whether it's lamps, the Topps cards. I love the Topps cards. We'll show you that in a little bit. But I think I'd just like to, I'll start from the beginning and kind of go over of my collection. So starting out, I've got the 12-inch, all of the original 12-inch figures here. And there wasn't a whole lot of those that they released out there. They had planned on jumping into the Empire, but you know, there's a few people that have the some specials that never got released out there, but it was just Star Wars. And then of course they came out with Boba Fett and then IG-88, and I've got all his missiles, and that's all of these are complete. I know that the Han Solo has two versions of the necklace, the ceremonial necklace that they've got. So that's the 12-inch line right there. This right here is the R2-D2 that's remote control. That's cool, it still works. And this right here, you remember when they had the Evel Knievel that you would run and they would go across the deal, sparks and all. That's what this is right here. This is the good guy van and the bad guy Darth Vader van. They're funny, right? They're pretty cool. I still have the little section pull spring thing here that you stick through the deal and you just woo, and you put on the ground and it's pretty cool. So it's not necessarily an order, but this is just how I have it set up for now. Jumping right here, this right here is the original necklaces that they came out with, and I actually forever was looking for this stand and I was able to find it, and it's awesome. It has the May the Force Be With You, Darth Vader for the Darth Vader necklace, and then the Stormtrooper. one. And you know, it's funny because out of all of my collection, out of all of the collection, this one little thing right here, this little simple with the moving arms 3PO, has such a special meaning. And that's what I'm saying. It doesn't matter how much it is. It's like you can have, you know, $500,000 in Star Wars, or you can just have this simple little thing and just what it did for you way back in the day. And I can tell you that right there, it brings a lot of good memories and some really struggling times in my life. And I was only 7 years old. Moving on past this right here, I've got the speakerphone. I won it one day when I would always go on Saturdays to watch a movie, get a slice of pizza and a drink, and I would always go buy one Star Wars figure. Anyway, I won that in the arcade, and I still have it today. This right here is just an old, when I was little, Chewbacca. And then I've got, you know, when the movies were released, I've got some of the little the buttons and whatnot. Those are pretty cool. So then here we have is the die-cast here, and I've got the complete collection of the die-cast, and a lot of you vintage people out there are familiar with the hard-to-get one, and that would be this right here, the TIE Bomber. You can see that it's yellowed in the wings and in the front on the plastics, and the metal is maintained. If a lot of you people out there don't know, what you can do is you can put these in peroxide. When I first got this thing, you know, obviously it's yellowed over time, but and there's not much you can do. It's, they're, you know, 40 plus years old. But if you are to put it in peroxide in a clear glass and set it out in the sun, they do whiten. The only problem is a year later, they yellow again. There's just not much you can really do about it. But it's a really, really cool piece, especially considering it was before Empire. So pretty neat. And then, of course, we've got all those. So yeah, we have the Star Destroyer, and it has the little ship right there. Slave One, Snowspeeder, and then we've got your Y-Wing, your Falcon. This was my first one. I love the Falcon. The Land Speeder. It's not to scale, obviously. Darth Vader's ship, the Twin Pod, and the X-Wing and the TIE. So those are pretty cool, and the wings pop off and whatnot. I'm missing the bomb off of my Y-Wing, but I'll find one. I know they make repros or something, but I try to find the originals if I can. Within reason, if it's a gun or something you're trying to collect, I don't think there's a problem with the repro. Moving on, here's the Death Star Space Station. Love this one here. It's got the little turn-in on the, and smashes up in the trash compactor and whatnot. I remember playing with that so well. I love that piece. Okay, moving down, because we're going to stick with Star Wars. I've got, of course, everyone knows the remote sandcrawler, and it's complete. Got the droid factory right here. Got the cantina with the original backing and whatnot. Now, this piece right here is one of my big pieces. This is what I've had since I was a kid, and it's in excellent shape, is the Sears mail-away Greedo, Snaggletooth, and, you know, Hammerhead, Walrus Man. But this is the one where you would get the blue Snaggletooth, which is right there. That's the original one, and he's in great shape. That one came with that. That's a really neat little piece. Of course, we got the Dewback and the Land Speeder here. The Land Speeder is pretty cool. And they have a bigger version of the Land Speeder, which is the Sonic one. And it's a little bit different in scale, as you can see. So that one's pretty cool. I still have to put all the little pieces where they need to go in the droid factory. I haven't done that because I've been moving things around and trying to get things organized. This is the mail-away stand with I have a bunch of sets of the original 12, but this one I have up here for I have my originals in another room. I'll show you guys shortly. But so we got that, and I don't know if a lot of you guys know, but everyone knows the vinyl cape Jawa, right? Everyone knows about the vinyl cape. But, and they know about the regular cloth cape, which hands down I think looks a lot better, and what the gun looks like. Well, this right here, A friend of mine donated to the gallery. His name's John. Super, super classy, cool dude. He's my buddy now. And this Jawa comes with a black gun that's very familiar with the gray guns with the Cloud Car Pilot. But the difference between this Little Eddy Mexican version versus the regular standard cape version is this one has a removable cape top. And a lot of people didn't even know about this. I actually didn't know about it till I met John. And I was like, you know, I had a packaged vinyl cape, which is really cool. But when I found out about this one, I was like, oh, I need to have it. And to find them with a cape is very, very rare. And just this cape, the hat is, it's really hard to find and rare. And I love this. Make sure I don't lose this while I'm talking. So this piece I might have showed in another video. This is a grail piece, and all you vintage collectors out there are going to know exactly what I'm talking about. This right here is a Canadian, I believe European. I know they had a couple different versions where they had different languages on the cardboard and whatnot for the trash compactor. But to find this piece in this condition is, it's just, there's not a lot of them out there, especially when you can get it with the lid right here. This is all original pieces. These are usually very yellow where you can't even see inside them, and this thing is clear as a bell. I love it. But yeah, this is as a kid, this one probably might have even been a little bit more fun to play with than the American version, which obviously has a little bit more to it. So moving on, also, I don't know if I mentioned the Land of the Jawas. We've got the Land of the Jawas back here. And then moving on to, we've got some Star Wars stuff down here. We've got that your X-Wing. Everyone knows about your Millennium Falcon, your TIE Fighter. This is another Sears special order or catalog mail order. I used to love when the Sears books would come out. That was awesome. I loved the Sears catalogs. I couldn't wait when it would come in, and I'd scroll through the back and look and see all the new Star Wars stuff that was coming out and whatnot. That was fun. Twin Pod Cloud Car, got Slave One, the Y-Wing, and got a lot of the cases. And again, none of this is in order right now, so sorry about that. But I'm sure if you're out there and you're a fan and you're a collector, you know what's up. So got all the TIE Interceptor, the Ewoks, more vintage. That's the Return of the Jedi blaster back there. So moving up, back up. This is all the Empire Hoth section over here. This is a cool one and a rare one. This is a mail away figure stand. And we also have the mail away where you send the proof of, if you're not getting an action figure, you could send away and get the little backpacks and the little respirators and the guns and all that cool stuff. It's crazy how much vintage guns have gone up. Vintage guns, you know, not repros, but the vintage ones, I mean, they sell for $20-$30 for a gun. And I remember having boxes of those things. I don't anymore. I sure wish I wouldn't have lost that stuff, but like all of us, right? Wish we never blew up Luke Skywalker. I never did that. But anyway, so here's the Snowspeeder. Here's, I've got the Tauntauns. They had your regular Tauntaun, and then they had your open belly Tauntaun. So, and it's over time, but, and then a couple more pieces over here. This is another, I believe, I can't remember if I got that at Toys R Us, but it still has the Land of the Jawas platform. There was a couple pieces that came out. I'll move this out of the way so you can see it. There's that one too that has the same Land of the Jawas. It's just white. So there's a couple different Hoth versions of that piece. And everybody recognizes the transport. I don't know if you guys had a chance to see my studio transport, but it's pretty, pretty cool. You have to check that out in the studio scale video. And then of course one of my favorite pieces is the AT-AT. I love the AT-AT. And then the AT-ST chicken walker, whatever you want to call that one. And then there was two versions of this too. The little transport, I've got both versions. The other one's over there, but basically it's a decal version. Everything else is the same on it. They just changed the decals, and it's the same molds and whatnot. And then, of course, they had the little mini car sets, the little pieces and whatnot. And then moving down, we went over that. And then we've got this is the vintage Rancor. And you collectors out there, and maybe fans that don't know, the Rancor's been pretty popular in 2021, late 2020, 2021. We're getting ready to get a fantastic replica of Tom Spina Designs, which is Regal Robot, of the Rancor. Unfortunately, 83 of them were sold, and 83 is all that's gonna come out. So who knows, maybe you'll find it on the secondary market, but it's a great piece. Also a really, really cool piece is the Sideshow version of the Rancor. And I think that the Sideshow version, it's really big, and a couple buddies of mine are just, they're torn because, I mean, it's just, it's so big, but yet I don't think Sideshow did it justice. They should have advertised it as almost like a six scale prop, like the Dewback. If they did, I think they would have sold out immediately because it's pretty much right on. I've seen a couple videos on it and it's huge. Mine should be here in a couple weeks, and we're gonna do a video on that actually. I look forward to that. So anyways, moving on off the Rancor. We've got the B-Wing down there and a couple more of the little mini vehicle rigs. The mini rigs is what they called them. And then we've got the almighty Jabba and his little partner in crime there. And then we've got the Dagobah, and moving around here, we've got a couple of the blasters. And this is the mini collection, which is the little metal figures mini collection. I do have the A-Wing and a couple other pieces that are just not up here because I'm trying to display things a little bit different. So bear with the mess. And then we've got the little puppet, Yoda puppet. Right, Yoda? Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's cool. Hand doesn't fit in there. He used to fit in there really easy. Okay. So that's pretty much it on the vintage right here. There's a couple things else that I'd like to show you on the vintage side that I like that's close to me. And when it comes to the vintage, the Topps cards, I mentioned it in one of my first videos, I love the vintage cards. Remember the stickers? You had these things plastered everywhere. They're still readily available, you can find them. It's not hard to get a complete collection of the old ones, and still today they sell these Topps cards. They're awesome. So here I have your blue section, which was the original phase that they came out with, and then they came out with the red, and I've got the decals separate here. And then of course I went into the yellow and into the greens, and then the orange, which was like the making of the movie. And what was really cool, I was able to find, I have all the original packages. I have some, these things sold for 15 cents. And these are the original boxes right here. And I got all of the original packages. And again, like I said, I have some packages that still have the gum. I've never opened up the package to see what that gum would taste like, you know, like a rock maybe. But anyways, I love these. So these are my original vintage figures. It goes all the way to droids, but it's got your original 12, and then moving on up, and I do have these. But what's so special about these are all mine. I'm 51 years old, and I started getting these figures. This was my first one, which is the R2-D2, and I mentioned that in a couple of videos in the past, but I've got a lot of the variances. It's just that these are just the main ones that I have in this collector's shelf. So we're wanting to do something a little bit different, but this is in my home office. And but these are the special ones to me right here. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching the episode in regards to my vintage collection. I hope it was enjoyable to you. And don't forget, if you guys have any comments, don't hesitate to reach out and ask. I'll do the best I can to answer them correctly, right? So on my next show, what we're going to be talking about is not just my life-size collection, but a lot of friend of mine collectors out there's collection, and wanted to get into the 3D design of life-size collecting, because that's getting really big. I've got a lot of things that I'm working on personally. I'm working on a life-size Darth Vader, which is really cool. A friend of mine, Joseph, is helping me on that, as well as another guy, Sean. I'm excited. So life-size Vader, and then this is the crazy one. I can't wait to show you guys. It should be the first one out of the box. I know there's a couple people making it, which is a life-size probe droid. This thing's almost 8 feet tall. It's crazy cool. But we're going to be talking to the people who do the files, the people that, you know, create these things, and then they send to the guys who actually print them and build them. There's a lot of work behind it, and that's what I wanted to talk to you guys about. But, you know, it's affordable. You can look at some of these life-size things on Sideshow and whatnot, and they're, you know, $8,000, you know, and, you know, you could build them for $1,500, you know, if you do it right and you're a do-it-yourself or it's fun, especially if you've got family members that like to help you. I've got a little girl, Haley, that a lot of you guys have had so many nice things to say about. She's my little baby girl, and she comes over and she helps me with some of my life-size builds because it's fun. I love that stuff. I mean, you're in the presence of real people kind of thing. It's really cool. Anyways, listen, I just want to say one more time, thanks so much for watching. You guys are super awesome. I wish you could all be here with me. I love talking Star Wars, but at least you're tuning in, right? Listen, I can't wait to talk to you next time. May the Force be with you. Say bye, R2. Man, he's always doing that. Hey, friends, and don't forget, go to me and my buddy Gabe's page at Collection Wars. We just kicked off a new podcast and we're really excited. We're just talking everything Star Wars, anything that has to do with collecting in this type of industry, whether it's the toys, the prop replicas, the life size. It's a great conversation and we'd love for you guys to tune in on it.
Let me ask you, sir, let's get your opinion of these toys and also the movie. You saw Star Wars, I guess.
I didn't see much of it, but I saw half of it at my friend's house. He has a tape of it, but and they switched it to another part of it, so I didn't get to see all of it.
How about the toys? You still like playing with the toys? What do you do with them?
I really take care of them.
That's good. That's good. That's a good way to get some more too. But do you like make scenes up from the movie or something like that, or make up your own stories? Or
I make up my own stories.
And then use the figures, move them around.
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen any commercials for the new stuff that's coming out, the new Star Wars stuff?
I saw a couple of things.
What do you think?
I think they're good.
You think it might make it on your Christmas request list?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Project Terror. This episode's going to be about the two-headed transplant. Y'all don't even know what I'm talking about.